string theory is a framework which is ambitious, and it tries to unify all these different aspects of physics from the very small to the very large, an attempt to try to describe what everything is made of and how the forces between particles work. Usually the forces between particles come by colliding or merging of the particles. In the context of string theory, the basic entities, basic objects are like little strings, like little loops. And these little loops or little circles move around and they come and join together. So if you have two circles coming and forming one circle, that creates an interaction between two, and then they can split again, and that kind of interaction is like a force. The fact that it unifies all the particles into one entity is what string theory does. When I was young, in elementary school, I was always baffled by things around me, even as simple as why doesn't the moon fall on people's head, and why don't people get bothered by the fact that it doesn't seem to fall. So those are the beginnings. And then later I remember when I saw some of my cousins working under physics, my older cousins working under physics problem sets, and I said, what are you doing? They said, well, we're trying to use this equation to find where the trajectory of a projectile lands. So what's the projectile's path and where does it land? And I was shocked that they can use mathematical equations, simple equations, to find where this thing falls. I said, you mean you can just tell me what's going to happen to that? I said, yeah, just this equation. And I was finding that amazing. The connections between geometry and physics goes all the way back to the Greek mathematicians and philosophers. They thought understanding Platonic solids would explain all the elements and explain all the natural forces and laws and so forth. Well, that was a fascination with geometry and the belief that somehow it has something to do with the reality around us. That aspect began to be more and more evident, especially in past century when Einstein found the geometry can explain gravitational force. So geometry is a way to think about gravity, and we began to become more embracing of geometric explanation of physical phenomena. In the context of modern developments in the past 50 years, in the context of string theory, we have seen how true and how even more important that relation is. Geometry implies physics, and physics implies structures in geometry. The new institute that's being inaugurated, I think, is a great idea, because it brings focus on the most exciting developments in the past 50 years in theoretical physics, which is the relation between physics and geometry. Physics and geometry together has proved to be an amazingly powerful tool in answering puzzles in physics on the one hand, and at the same time shedding light to deep questions in mathematics. Understanding just pure mathematical questions seem to be aided by physical intuitions gained in the context, in particular, of string theory and quantum field theories. So this relation between physics and geometry is useful for both, and it's continuing to develop. And we are far from the end of the story, and we need more effort in that direction. And this institute would be a great push in that direction.